today I'll just be taking you through a quick tutorial on how I do my everyday makeup. I've started with a bare face, but as you can see, one of my eyebrows is done. This one. And I'm just going to show you quickly how I do the other one before I move on to eye makeup. I just drag down from the top of the arch to shape the back bit first. And then fill in the back with a slightly heavier hand that I'm going to do the front. And then I connect that arch shape to the main area of my brow. Like so. And then lightly just fill in the front with softer pencil strokes as I get to the front of my eyebrow. Generally, if I make a mistake with my brows, or if I'm not happy with the shape of them, I'll take some concealer and I use Boing from Benefit in the lighter shade. And I'll take a brush. I'm just going to use this plain angled brush. And just lightly go over the area I'm not happy with. The next step I usually do with my eye makeup to minimise fallout when I've got my base on. And I always prime my eyelids. Some of my favourite primers are the Shadow Insurance, the Too Faced Shadow Insurance. But I also like MAC Soft Ochre. Today I'm just going to be using the Shadow Insurance because I feel like it's good enough to do the job. Soft Ochre is really good if you're trying to cut a crease. So, as you can see, I've just blended some yellow into my eyes. I'm going for a look that goes with the Renaissance palette, though I do feel like this could have more of a yellowy shade in it. I am really happy with the MAC one, and this is my all-time favourite palette, but I feel like a couple of the shades, like these three, are very similar, and one of them could have been swapped out for yellow. I know many people may disagree. Next, I'm taking this brush, which is like a soft blending brush, and I'm going into Love Letter, and I'm just blending that into my crease and around the corner of my eye. And I'm just going to go back in with my yellow brush and blend out any harsh lines or edges. Now I'm just going to go back in with Love Letter to deepen the intensity of the colour. The next colour I'm using is still once again from this palette, and it's Red Ochre. I'm using my Morphe M322 brush just to buff it in to the very outside corner and just around the crease, just to give it a bit more depth. As you can see, I've just pushed it up into that yellow shade. And then I'm just going to go ahead and sculpt the inside corner of both of my eyes Usually I would do this with MAC Soft Ochre, but that's not in my kit right now, so I'm just going to use a tiny bit of the Boing Concealer on the same brush we used the concealer on earlier. Oh, I cut the inner corner of both of my eyes, and I'm going to just blend that concealer in a bit. I'm just going to set it with Tempura from my Modern Renaissance palette, which is probably my most used shade ever. As you can see, it's just opened the inner corner of both of the eyes. Next, generally, I move on to base, and today I am using the NARS foundation. All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation in the shade Light 2, which is Mont Blanc. Though I do believe I could go a shade lighter. I wouldn't rebuy this foundation, but it works. It's okay, but I wouldn't. I'm using it because it's expensive and I bought it. So just put a little bit on the back of my hand, as you only need a very little bit with this foundation. And I'm first of all just one thing I do like about this foundation is, as it's relatively medium coverage, you can still see some features of the face through it, like freckles. And Ben Nye Neutral Set Powder. I'm just tipping a bit out. Using a sponge, I'm just packing that onto the areas of my face that I need to set more strongly than others. I'm just firmly patting it down with the sponge and then taking my Real Techniques Duo Fiber Face Brush and a little bit of the Neutral Set Powder. I'm just brushing it around and brushing off the bits I've just packed on. Generally next I go in with my contour powder, and my favourite for this is Benefit's Hoola, and this is just a sample, but I've been using it for 6 months on myself and others occasionally, and I'm barely halfway through it. For this I take this Morphe brush, which is from the Candy Apple set, doesn't have a specific number, and I'm just buffing it around the hollow area of my cheeks. As I'm naturally quite pale, contour has usually shows up quite dark on my skin and can have a tendency to go very patchy and very orange. And I like the Hoola for that because generally it doesn't. But if you feel like you need a bit more of a blend, take a dense brush such as the is a Real Techniques one, but the name has rubbed off. I'm sure someone knows the gist of the brush anyway. And just drag it down around my cheeks to blend in the remainder of the product. And usually I find that that is enough contouring for a day-to-day basis. My highlighter, at the moment I'm loving the Kat Von D Alchemist palette, which doesn't want to show up to you in this light. try the other side?
Yeah.
And I do love all of the shades, but I think I'm going to go for the pink opal as it complements my eyeshadow quite nicely. And I'm here I highlighted my cheekbones, the inner corner of my eyes, under my eyebrows, and the bridge of my nose, and my cupid's
bow. Onto my eye makeup to just do the finishing touches, which is underneath the waterline, my eyeliner, my mascara, and false lashes, if I am applying them. If you're in, is I'm going in with my eyeliner, which is the Kat Von D Tattoo Liner in Trooper. And I'm just going to create a smallish cat eye. I have gone for quite a thick eyeliner today. Whether that was on purpose or not, I'll leave you to decide. And I'm just going to go underneath my eye and add a little bit of colour there just to bring the whole look together. So I'm going in with that MAC yellow again. It's my MAC palette. Just dipping into that MAC yellow and blending it all under our eye. Using this little accent brush, I'm going to go back in to Love Letter and just blend it towards the outside. And then right in the waterline, I'm just going to pack Cypress Umber, which is this dark brown, just to give my eyes a little bit more definition. I don't quite like what this eyebrow's doing at the front. So once again, I'm gonna go in with the concealer. I need a touch more concealer on that brush. Don't think there's any left on it. And I'm just gonna darken up the front of the brow. And then I'm just going in with my lip liner, with my lipstick, sorry, we've just done lip liner. I'm just going to finish the look by adding some false lashes and some mascara, so I will be back in a second. So this is the finished look. I've just added some false lashes and a little bit more highlighter, though you can't see the highlight brilliantly in this light. Please like and subscribe if you'd like to see more. Okay, thank you for watching.